this is Firefalco 2-0.
Calgary for a maniac.
This is, sorry, Lake 6694.
Anyway.
Epic fail?
Yes. Wow. Anyway, we are still here for Wiicast July. Even though it's August.
This is weird, yeah, we had a mix up.
It's always a little bit white.
What? Oh. Yeah, get closer to the mic, yeah. Okay, so let's see. Should we get into currently playing?
Sure.
No.
Yes.
Okay, so maybe. What has everybody been playing this week?
Chips Challenge.
And how is that?
Kind of interesting.
Wow. Yeah, applause, really.
Clap.
Okay. Okay, now, what else? What have you been playing, Firefalco?
Well, my friend comes over every other week with his Wii, and we've been playing, like, Mario Kart, Smash Brothers. He has Need for Speed. I'm beastly at that. Okay. I'm really good. I figured out I'm really good at Need for Speed, all around, with drag, with grip, and all that, so... also on the DS, I've played Transformers, Revenge of the Fallen, Decepticons. I've actually bought the new Bleach game, Bleach Dark Souls, which is really good. And that's pretty much it.
Okay, so what have I been playing? Well, I've been trying to get my lungs out of control and that sort of stuff. But in games wise, I've been playing In Plus for the DS. I've been playing. which is a great DS game. You should definitely... What are you doing?
He farted.
Okay, this is so confusing. Okay, so In Plus is basically you're a ninja and you're walking around this town. Please don't flash me.
It's a 2D game, isn't it? It's like 2D... It looks like...
Yes.
Game & Watch or something. Or Mario.
I think it's definitely one of the best platformers on... but it's definitely a really good platformer. Definitely check out. It's $12, and my review will hopefully be up soon. I've been also playing crap, like Circus Game. Crap. Shovelware is all it is. Then we have Pets, Horses, 2.
Yeah, because we're trying to get a reputation for kid-friendly stuff.
I mean, well...
Yes, we're looking.
Well, the Walt...
Dara.
Okay, thank you, audience.
Oh.
Yeah, really.
Okay, little so, midgets in the background. Thank you, midgets.
As you can tell, we're definitely testing a lot of new style things. So our first topic of this Wiicast is... Speaking of Game & Watch, Game & Watch games will now be available for download on the Nintendo DSiWare for 200 points each, starting in Japan very soon.
How soon?
Oh yeah.
Wait for it. And it's done. Keep going.
Okay, yeah. Well, it seems like a pretty quiet month for the champ with just 3 WiiWare games and that sort of stuff, but... I mean, Game & Watch has always been my kind of favorite kind of thing. With reviewing Game & Watch collection, since I am the voice of Flatso, I've really gotten to appreciate some of these older games. And my uncle actually has some of the old ones, so I've been able to play a couple of those. They're really fun. And I highly recommend. Yeah. So, what do you guys think about this coming to the DSiWare? Are you excited?
Yeah, since everyone... since Game & Watch kind of got a hit on Brawl, he's kind of come back after the really old handheld games that he was on. So, yeah, I think that's pretty good.
What do you think, Calc?
I don't have a DSi.
Well,
I don't either, but still.
Well, what are you excited about the idea, though? At least they're coming back as remakes.
Sure.
Good. Okay.
At least act.
Yeah, act. Just act like
you.
Yeah. 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 Dinner. Okay, so...
Banana.
What?
Banana.
Okay.
For dinner.
Banana. Yeah. Okay.
Oh,
wait.
Okay.
Do we know that?
Can you stop her laughing? Use duct tape or something?
Okay. So, this is kind of a weird kind of topic. So, a fitness blogger wants health warning labels on game cases. Nintendo in general, overall, I give Nintendo credit for trying to make a game that tries to get people to be more active, which
yeah,
is more than can be said. Yeah, it is than Wii Sports. Now I lost my place, thanks. To get more active, which can be said for other video game manufacturers. However, this will not do anything in terms of chopping away at the American obesity problem. In fact, I'll go out on a limb and say the video game industry needs to follow the route of the tobacco and alcohol manufacturers and state that excessive use of their product could lead to inactivity and obesity, rather than trying to make a half-hearted effort at increasing America activity levels. Quote unquote from Winston-Salem Fitness blog. And
oh, that was from Winston-Salem?
Sorry, that's the name.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, that's the name. Winston-Salem. I don't even know where that is.
Winston-Salem?
Yeah, not really. It sounds like it comes from Europe. It's in Europe. Right?
Oui, oui.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, yes. Sorry about that. We had a little
That was Europe.
Yeah.
We had a little technical difficulties.
Yeah,
didn't want to talk to them.
Okay, I can't stand this kind of talk personally. Playing games does not make you overweight. It's the food you eat that makes you overweight. If you play a lot of games...
If you're the guy in your mom's basement, stuck with a bag of chips, and... Yeah, in their basement, in her basement playing... Yeah, you'll get fat if you're not active. But if you just spend a few hours playing, and then go outside and move, you're fine.
Yeah, but that's what I was saying, though. It's like, if you play a lot of video games, eat healthy, and do exercise, you will most likely be healthy. Games do not equal cigarettes. I mean, seriously.
That's what I do. Look, six-pack.
Yeah, yeah, really. Excessive use of anything is bad for you, so.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Gotcha. Exactly. Okay, so...
If you see pretty lights on the screen, stop
So, using. What do you guys think about this fitness label? Do you think they should put this on video games?
No.
Put maybe the same health... Yeah, they shouldn't really change anything. They do put health warnings, like...
In the manuals.
Yeah,
and when you start up a Nintendo...
Like, if your vision starts being blurry, or if you had seizures or something beforehand, playing video games,
But and they also do that when you start up the Wii, you have that health and safety.
Instead of being like, warning, you go fat playing this game.
No, won't work.
There goes sales.
Yeah, what did you think about this, Calc? Go ahead, say something.
Speak. That was him and you.
Yeah, can we get some awesome music playing just to do this?
That's not awesome
music. Wait, what's that noise? When I said awesome music, I didn't mean violin.
Violins are awesome.
Yeah.
To a point.
Try to find some country music or something.
I don't care.
Or some rock. That's better.
August Rush works too.
Okay, so speaking of guitars, Guitar Hero 5 details. So here we go.
Can't wait for that.
So here's one of the new features that you can do in Guitar Hero. You can import your Guitar Hero World Tour / Smash Hits to Guitar Hero 5 for a fee. On the PS3, Xbox 360, and Wii, some of the disc-based songs from the Guitar Hero World Tour and Smash Hits will be importable for a fee. To work with Guitar Hero 5 and the upcoming Band Hero, what's more, currently 152 out of 158 Guitar Hero World Tour downloadable tracks will automatically work with Guitar Hero 5. All of the songs you import will be upgraded to work in the new Guitar Hero 5 features, such as band moments and vocal star power. It's something we've wanted to do this for a long time, quote-unquote. from the developers. There are separate licenses, so we need to go back and relicense previous content and that sort of stuff. So what do you guys think about being able to bring songs from World Tour and smash hits to Guitar Hero 5?
Oh yeah, I loved World Tour. When my friend would come over, I forgot to mention this, we would also play World Tour. And we would just go on Wi-Fi or something and beat the crap out of somebody.
I know, exactly. Yeah.
Like, show off your skills, expert, and then...
Yeah, really. Like,
and,
Guitar Hero through the fire and the flames.
Yeah. That was three.
Yeah, I know, but...
Personally, I liked the little touch screen. It was confusing, like, going back and forth, but still. And then Guitar Hero 5.